This is Tyler. Sometimes his job is dangerous. Not this job, his real job, testing snowboards.
Oh. My elbow just fucking ran into the, like, I came off the feature and my hand hit in my, I don't know, my neck.
Are you absolutely sure you want to set foot into such a mysterious realm? You may get lost in there and not be able to find your way back.
You are about to witness the last chapter of an epic journey. 25 days, 4,000 miles, 8 mountains, and 9 board insides. Tyler, Javi, Levi, Peyton, Greg, Jeremy, Tanner, and Lars, we saw some products. We drove in a car, played pool, rode some skateboards, we rode some snowboards, we rode more snowboards, we jumped over trees, we got on our inner chi.
Now right, now left.
We reconnected with family and visited makers of things that fuel our obsession.
This is quite literally one of one in North America.
Learned some history and met people with a similar passion as ours.
Hey, nice to meet you.
We hiked and hiked and hiked. And we rode even more snowboards. Which is pretty awesome. Oh, and we danced.
Strippers.
Mike Wilmer.
Bands that make her dance. All these chicks popping. See, I'm just popping bands. Bands that make her dance. These chicks clap, and they ain't using
test
hands.
Test the West. Oregon, the Pacific Northwest. The last stop on the Test the West journey.
Not ready at all.
You a little worried?
No.
Everybody got their Snickers at least?
I just don't want to sweat.
We felt like we didn't have enough drama, so we set it up so that we had to do this, right? Not really. All right.
Without tickets, Tanner, Tyler, and Tyler set off on the day's challenge. Another hike. Is this the world's fastest dog or what?
This is gonna be a long hike. Woo! Lingwall's a little bit behind. He had to tie up his boots at the bottom. Made it.
There's nothing more satisfying than ooey gooey caramel, nuts, chocolate, and nougat after a long hike up an icy face.
For $5, snowboard Jesus will put himself on his snowboard crucifix and bring 5 inches down upon this hill. For $10, I will let you suspend yourself upon my snowboard. You must have the balls to go through it, for this is not a comfortable feeling until you get used to it. Snowboard Jesus, here to stay. Rock stack on top of the world. No, it'll be like 1 minute.
All right, what are you guys gonna go, skiers right or skiers left, or right down the middle?
We're just gonna kind of come down the face, kind of
towards the parking lot.
Okay.
At the launch, but where we're at, kind of.
Oh, gotcha. I'm more in the middle of the park.
Yeah, we can
see where you're at. We'll stay in the line of sight at least.
All right.
We won't go too far to the right, then we're out of your shot.
Sounds good.
All right, so I'm gonna put the phone away. You're already filming, so we'll drop in about 1 minute.
All right.
Okay, boys, let's get strapped in. He's already filming.
Mt Bachelor!
This time, with lift tickets in hand, we got to really experience the mountain.
Dilly dally, I ran through the alley, bumped into this guy named Sally from the valley.
Insider's tip, snowboarding is always better when you're with a local.
With our tour guide, Levi Johnson, rocking some L2R boards. This looks like the Bachelor himself. We're about to go on a unique run. A lot of people say that only the locals know about this. You gotta walk up the stairs and around the backside of this building to even access the run. On a pow day, this is supposed to be impeccably amazing for wind lifts. Let's go see how it is. Area 52. They're calling us this way. What are you texting? I was gonna follow Ling, but he's just like doing his phone thing. There's longer gondola rides, maybe longer tram rides, but this is the longest just normal quad chairlift in North America. And it feels like it. You can't even see the end in sight. It's going up into the clouds and then some.
If you wanna get that long, slow chair, this is the chair.
Shit, man.
What? That's really icy.
That was really awesome.
Feelings about Mt Bachelor. It's amazing. It's an amazing place. It's an amazing journey. You can see the cone. That's where we started. Now we're here. Shred Jesus saves. Shred Jesus saves. $5. 5 inches. $5, 5 inches, please. Send your money. Snowboardjesus.com. He takes all donations, checks, cash. He'll take weed. It doesn't necessarily guarantee you the same amount of inches, but he does love it.
Government camp. Home the board insider snowboard testing. We connect with old friends and visit old haunts. Meet Roundhouse of Mount Hood 26. He's full of useful knowledge.
So you're using this shoulder.
I vote for mayor of government camp.
voice on the internet. I don't care what you say. Gingers do have souls. Gingers do have souls. They're light souls. They're like light imprints on the land. But they have souls.
Now to meet another maker of things, INI Cooperative. Maker of environmentally friendly snowboard outerwear.
There was a big push at SIA in sustainable outerwear. And we'd like to say that we had a big hand in that because we've been sustainable from the start. And that was something that we started. 75% of all of the garments we make for snow are made from recycled or reusable materials. It was great to meet you guys.
Last few hours till we're back in Seattle. Oh yeah. Check out our big old flat screen in our crib.
What?
Watch a movie while we're rolling down the street.
Picture me rolling.
And we now come to the end of our journey. Life as we know it will never be the same.
Nobody said it was easy. No one ever said it would be so hard. I'm going back to the start.
That's sexist, dude. Come on. Okay, what times? You gotta do real push-ups.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I don't think he's gonna make it.
8, 9, 10.
Oh, he's shaking.
10.
I sprinkled Parmesan on my pizza for like 2 minutes and you couldn't get the camera out in time.
Fail.
Here, just to make Tanner mad. That's enough, Tyler. That's enough.
Here.
Can you help me out? No, yeah, no, here. No, wait. Oh! I'll take it. That's Parmesan.
It's
and then I go like this. I only like 10 pepper sprays on top. Last year when my grandma passed away, I was at Mount Hood. And I got the news from my mom when I was on the hill and I went out and took a run. And there was a raven that took the whole run with me. Literally every turn I took, he stayed like 15 feet away from me. It was like my grandma shredding with me down the mountain. I saw this, I put it in my hair. I finished the hike knowing that's exactly where I was supposed to be today. I miss you, Grandma. Shaman love.